Hello. Oh my god, it's gonna be quite loud. I'll just turn the voice down later on. Okay, got a battle against Ranko. It's in 3x speed, so yeah. Right, she leads off with Pikachu, I lead off with Medicham. I'm so blatantly gonna fake out that yeah. She switches into a Bronzong to take it. Pretty standard stuff. And I don't really think I'm gonna sit in here. There's not much I can do to it, because I could force palm it, but that would paralyze it, and if it's a Bronzong with Gyro Ball, that's a crap idea. Sorry, I'm a bit under the weather, and I'm having to reiterate this, because I tried uploading it about half an hour ago, and it was about 30 seconds too long. So I go into Licky Licky, and, you've seen this Licky before. You know what it's gonna do. It's gonna Fire Blast it to hell and back. Lemsip, you are a god. And I'm actually quite surprised at how much this did, because Bronzong's not exactly weak, is it? But it did half, and this Licky Licky hasn't got a lot of special attack investment. Anyway, I dodge a Hypnosis, and I'm like, yeah, go Licky, and I go for Fire Blast, and it misses. I'm like, ah, damn it, Licky. Why? And she goes for a Gyro Ball, but because Licky's a fat bastard, doesn't do much. And I'm thinking, right, well, it's not going to kill it now, but I go for it again, and I miss, and she hits Hypnosis, and I'm like, yeah, why? But oh well. I've got Heelbeller and Togekiss, so I am not that bothered. I'll get on with it. What do I go into? Gliscor. I don't really have anything to do here. I don't know why I went into Gliscor, but it worked out. She went into Pinsir, and Pinsir can't do jack to me. Apart from Stone Edge, and even then, counter, dead. So I predict that, and I think I'll go over Taunt if she goes into Tangrowth. Yeah. Well, actually, no, I thought she might SD, but thinking about it, Pinsir might have been quicker anyway, which would have been quite funny. And then she knocks off my lefties, and I'm like, yeah. And then I counter it, and I get what? 22 damage? Ooh. That's gonna dent it. And then I'm sitting there thinking, right, I have EQ, Roost, Counter, and Taunt. I ain't doing jack, so may as well switch. I think I either go back into Licky or into Infernape. Or do I go into. No, I think I go into Medicham later. There's a really annoying bit coming up with Medicham, and it drove me nuts. Yeah, going to Infernape, because. You know, who the hell. Yeah, she knocks off again, knocks off my lefties, which kind of ruins Infernape a bit, but oh well. And I'm thinking, right, who the hell's gonna stay in against an Infernape when it's a Tangrowth? I can overheat. Especially when Infernape can do special or physical sets, or mixed. So, she can't stay in, she switches. I'm gonna capitalize on that and sob. In comes a Starmie, I'm thinking, well, overheating would be pointless. May as well just focus punch it. She breaks my sub, as I figured would happen. And, I land the focus punch, and it does like half? Yeah, decent amount. I was expecting it to be a bit more, because focus punch is such a beastly move, and Infernape isn't exactly a slouch, but there you go. So I switch into Regice, because Regice can take just about damn near anything. Because it's a Regice, no need for explanations there. And she's obviously going to switch, because nothing's happening with that. And I'm going to sub, which was kind of a waste. I probably should have predicted the Bronzong, but yeah, it didn't really factor in. So I'm at half health, and the Stealth Rocks are up, and this Bronzong has Gyro Ball, so. Not too good, but I'll get a charge. I probably should have gone for a Signal Beam. I don't know why I went for Charge Beam, but there you go. Signal Beam would have done more, and it would have been the smarter play. But I went with Charge Beam, so bleh. And I might have gotten Confusion Axe as well. But I'm about half health. I think I'm at exactly half, actually. And I believe I switch out into Infernape? Yeah, I think I just go straight into Infernape, which was kind of risky because some Bronzongs have EQ. Yeah, but no, she goes for the Gyro Ball, and I was amazed that did a crap ton when you consider I times 4 resist it. Yeah. So I was astounded. I was like, what the hell was that Bronzong doing? I know Infernape's weak as piss, but Jesus. So I overheat it, wreck its ugly face, even though it's not that ugly. But there you go. It's dead. Whatever. Dead. Get out. And now I'm sitting here. And my thought process is right. Starmie's gonna come in, but I can switch out. I think Stealth Rock. I live the Stealth Rock switch in, and I probably could have overheated again. But I was like, you know what? There isn't much point. I'd rather something else didn't take a hit. So I stay in, take the T-bolt, and die. It's just, if Regice came in, it couldn't take two Surfs, Togekiss couldn't take a T-bolt, you know. So I'm going to Medicham again, right? Fake out might kill it, but in reality, it's kind of a stupid play. Because, you know, Tangrowth could come in and Starmie resist both of my stabs. So, yeah. And even if I got a Paralyze, it can switch out thanks to natural kill. So I'm going Magikote, and she sleep powders for getting my Licky Lickies asleep, but it misses with Magikote, and I'm like, oh, why? So now I'm really grumpy. I'm like, oh, could have had a free sleep there. But no, she said, yeah, she just forgot about Licky, and I was like, meh, it happens. I'm not gonna go, oh, you tried to sleep me again, I'm gonna DC. Because humans are forgetful. It's our nature. So I go into Togekiss, predicting Leech Seed, I guess. I don't know why. I couldn't do anything. I probably should have gone into Regice straight away, but there you go. And it misses, which I'm quite thankful for. And I believe here I go with Heal Bell. I think. Yeah. I go with Heal Bell to get the sleep off Licky. I'm not really sure why, because in retrospect, when I Heal Bell, that Tangrowth could have just put me to sleep, and it'd be like, oh, that's pointless. But yeah, I Heal Bell. Licky wakes up. In comes Blissey. I go for an extreme speed, and I get a lucky crit. And I'm going to say it mattered a lot, because it factored in a lot more. Although, maybe not. Pardon me. Had to burp. Oh well. Here, I'm thinking, right. A crit extreme speed did two thirds. Another one would not kill it, because I got paralyzed, so. Bleh. Screw you, game. Nah, I don't really care. It's payback for the crit. So now I'm thinking, hang on a minute. Blissey's here, and I have a Licky Licky with explosion. So I'm thinking, right, let's do this now, or we'll never do it. So I switch into Licky Licky. Licky comes in. I think she goes with Ice Beam, which I found kind of weird, because you always see him packing that S-toss. I mean, I suppose if you don't want to deal with ghosts, fine, but it's not like Blissey's going to hurt a ghost anyway, and it mostly comes up against Dusknoir. She goes with T-Wave, thinking, ah, we got him now, and I go boom, and I'm like, oh, yes. Ah, that's beautiful. Look at its HP go down. The most powerful explosion in the game. Well, if you look at stab point of view and such, if I put choice band on it and max attack, dear God. But yeah, I think that takes the biscuit for the most just wonderful kill I've ever gotten. Anyway, she goes into Pikachu, and I go into Medicham thinking, well, she's probably going to go into Pikachu. You know, it makes sense. So I'm thinking, right, you know. Fake it out, but she's like, ah, I don't want to get damaged. So she goes right back into Tangrowth, and we've seen this all before. And now someone's. Oh, no, nothing. Now nothing's asleep. I go Magikote, she goes Sleep Powder, and I miss again. I'm like, ah, why, Tangrowth? You're such a git. And now I'm just angry. I'm like, well, you know, Medicham, you've done shit, haven't you? You've just effectively missed two free Sleep Powders, which you can't learn. Learn to value other players' mistakes, you bastard. So now I'm just gonna start slapping Tangrowth, and she starts whipping me back, and I'm like, woo! Woo, 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 that's not cool. Yeah. So, that's awful. And I force palm again, and I get the paralyze, which was very, very helpful. Very, very, very helpful. So, yeah, so. Manchamp goes down after being a pretty much a failure for the entire game. I'm sorry, Manchamp, but it's true. And I go into Regice. Kind of close to dying. And here is I go with Signal Beam. And actually, no, I don't know, I think Signal Beam was the best thing I had, because Icy Wind is like, what, 40 base power? Stab 60? So I think Signal Beam's more powerful. But either way, it doesn't kill it. And I'm like, oh shit. And then Power Whip misses. And I'm like, oh, hooray. So we're okay. Regice is still sort of cruising along, vaguely. And I take it out of an Icy Wind, just in case something wanted to come in. Although Signal Beam would hit the Starmie better. But, you know, whatever. Just in case, for the sheer hell of it. And in comes Pikachu. I'm like, right, even with the Light Ball, I can probably take a T-Bolt. And she has Brick Break, and I'm like, oh no, if you have Hidden Power Ice, I lose. Oh, that's what's going through my head. Because I, what, Gliscor and Togekiss? Nah, that ain't happening. So I go into Gliscor, and then I switch straight into Togekiss to see. And she uses Hidden Power Ice. I'm like, oh no, 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 I'm not losing to some stupid little electric rat. However, Togekiss, as it turns out, Adamant, max attack, is a fucking beast. Extreme speed one-shots it, and I'm like, woo! I mean, yeah, Pikachu is frail as anything, but I was surprised, I'm not gonna lie. In comes Starmie, and I'm like, well, if I can't kill this, I lose anyway. Extreme speed there, and it doesn't kill, it gets really close, that's the second time that's happened, but amazingly, that bulk I invest in Togekiss makes it live a T-Bolt. So I'm like, win? Pretty good Togekiss set. This has saved my ass a number of times. Or gotten me close to winning, anyway. So, you know, I'm still going. I'm amazed I haven't missed an extreme speed yet. I'm sitting there going, what the hell is going on? And, you know, I'm still trucking. And her last is Pinsir. So I know I've got it in the bag. So, you know, quick counter from Gliscor will end anything. I go for extreme speed, I missed. She goes for Stone Edge, she misses, and I'm like, wow, you know, it was bound to happen eventually. We both have 80 accuracy moves. And then I hit my extreme speed, and she misses her Stone Edge, and I'm like, wow, it's a bit gay, it's not really on, so I'll just heal battle and let you kill me off. You know, no biggie, I'm not going to sit here in extreme speed again. Although in a battle coming up later today, I do kind of dick about like that. Yeah, it takes explaining. And then I go into Gliscor, and then I counter for the win. So, great game, Ranko. Thank you for challenging me, because, like I say, you don't battle often. And you were nice enough to give me a battle when I asked. So, thanks for that. Anyway, in a bit, people.
And during the few moments that we have left, we want to talk right down to earth in a language that everybody here can easily understand.